In 1783, Britain acknowledged the independence of the United States of America. The new state conducted even more severe warfare against the native peoples than the British colonial powers had done. The fight against the settlers was continued by the great chief Tecumseh, Flying Arrow. After the deaths of his father and two eldest brothers, his third brother, Chesekau, took care of the young warrior's training. When Tecumseh was 13, he and his brother joined the Cherokees, who were fending off the colonists at that time. They spent 3 years here among constant clashes with whites in the southeastern region of North America. During his travels, Tecumseh became acquainted with dozens of tribes. Each was weak and defenseless on its own. But, like Pontiac, Tecumseh believed that they would become invincible if united. Tecumseh planned to create a Native American state, a united Indian nation, to counter the North American Union. When Tecumseh and his brother began organizing the Native Confederacy, aiming to stop the advance of the white man, Harrison, the governor of the territory of Indiana, tried to oppose him. Tecumseh rejected the agreement Harrison put forward in 1809, according to which the natives would have yielded a plot of land along the River Wabash and persuaded his comrades to defend this land. In response, Harrison decided to drive the Native Americans from their lands by force.
Thank you. We'll be right back.